Welcome back. In this video, we're going to take a look at how to use the calculator and the change of base formula to evaluate any logarithm. The change of base formula states that log base a of x is equal to log base b of x divided by log base b of a. So we're taking the log of the number and we're dividing by the log of the base. And what this says is that we can use any base that we want to determine the value of this log. And since the graphing calculator has the common log, or log base 10, and the natural log, or log base e, we'll use either of those two logs when we're applying the change of base formula. This can be proven fairly easily. If we let y equal log base a of b, then if we rewrite this in exponential form, we would have a to the power of y equals to b, as we see here. Now, if we take the log of both sides with base c, where c would be any base, we would have this equation here. And then if we applied the power property of logarithms, where we can take this exponent and multiply it by the logarithm, and when we divide by log base c of a on both sides, we have this result. But remember that y was equal to log base a of b, which is the change of base formula. Again, this base c can be any base we want, but we'll use either the common log or natural log, since that's what's on the calculator. Okay, before we do some of these problems, let's just do a quick review of what we can do with the calculator. Let's go ahead and evaluate these and then write an exponential equation to show what it actually means. Remember, a logarithm is an exponent. So when we calculate natural log 37, the result will be an exponent. So we'll say this is approximately 3.6109. Remember, natural log is base e. So what this tells us is if we raise e to this power, we'll have approximately 37. So e to the power of 3.6109 is approximately 37. Number 2 can also be done on the calculator without the change of base formula, because this is common log, or log base 10. So let's go ahead and determine this approximate value on the calculator. Log 295. It's approximately 2.4698. So again, what that means is 10 to the power of 2.4698 is approximately equal to 295. Let's go and take a look at some logs now that aren't base e or base 10. So it says use the calculator and the change of base formula to determine each value, then write an exponential equation using that value. So again, we're going to use either common log or natural log, and I'll show both, but let's just go ahead and use common log here. The change of base formula states we can take the log of 125 and divide by the log of the base, log 5. And this will give us this value. Let's try it. Log 125 divided by log 5 should give us 3, and it does. And just to show that we could have used natural log, I'll take the natural log of 125 divided by natural log of 5, and we also get 3. Because remember, the change of base formula is valid for the log of any base. So what this means is 5 to the third power is equal to 125. Number 2, we have log base 7, which is not on the calculator, but we can take the common log of the number 89 and divide by the common log of the base. And let's go ahead and see what that gives us. So this is approximately 2.3067. So again, what that means is 7 raised to the power of 2.3067 is going to be approximately 89. And let's go ahead and just verify that. So if we take 7 and raise it to the power of 2.3067, we can see it's approximately 89. It's a little bit off because we did round to 4 decimal places. Let's go ahead and take a look at one more. Log base 2 of 36. Again, log base 2 is not on the calculator, so we can use the change of base formula. So we'll take the common log of 36 and divide by the common log of the base. Be careful not to try to simplify here, that won't work. Let's go to our calculator. log 36 divided by log 2, approximately 5.1699. Which tells us if we take base 2 and raise it to the power of 5.1699, it should equal approximately 36. And let's go ahead and verify that one as well. 2 to the power 5.1699, and you can see it is approximately 36. So the change of base formula is very valuable to help evaluate logarithms. Okay, I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you and have a good day.